was told that the theme this year is from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. In other words, we're encouraged to follow the biblical principle of giving in proportion to all that God has given us. Well, my self-deprecating sense of humor immediately goes to, God gave me an abundance of fat cells. And am I supposed to match that abundance financially? I can't. I'm a teacher, for goodness sake. I don't have that salary. But when I think about it further, I realize God didn't give me the fat cells. It was Chick-fil-A and Krispy Kreme and Reese Cups aided and abetted as well. All of this blaming and reflecting reminded me of an excerpt from a book I read years ago, Having a Merry Heart and a Martha World. The author, Joanna Weaver, tells the following story to give a visual to the reader about understanding what's important and how to achieve balance in our lives. The story is told of the man who meets God one day. God asks him to take a wagon with 3 stones to the top of the mountain. God gave the man specific instructions, he sketched a map in the dust, and the man cheerfully set off pulling that wagon behind him. While he was going through a small village, a friend stopped and asked him what he was doing. He explained he was taking the wagon of rocks to the top of the mountain. The friend became excited as he explained he was going to do the same thing and would he be able to take his rocks to the top of the mountain. Happily, the man with the wagon took the friend's rocks and started on his way. Well, as he went along, more and more people were asking him to take their rocks with him up the mountain. The wagon felt huge and awkward as it lumbered and swayed over the ruts in the road. No longer was the man singing praises. Instead, resentment began to build inside. Frustrated, the man was about to just give up and let the wagon roll backwards. About that time, God came to his side and asked what the problem was. "You gave me a job that was too hard," the man sobbed. God walked over to the wagon, said, "What is this?" and held up a big rock and threw it on the ground. The man explained how there had been other people asked him to bring it up the mountain. God continued unloading the wagon until he got to the 3 rocks that he initially asked the man to take up. "Let others shoulder their own belongings," God said gently. "I know you are trying to help, but when you are weighted down with all of these cares, you can't do what I have asked of you." But throughout my years of momming, I felt as if I needed to volunteer in all the things in which my children have been involved. There was truly a year when I was a room mother for 3 teachers. I was the chair of a silent auction. I was the volunteer coordinator for an elementary school. I was a swim team chair treasurer. And I was a vacation Bible school coordinator. I recall screaming, my God, why have you forsaken me? I had totally not mastered the word no at this point, but I'm learning to prayerfully consider what God is asking me to do versus the PTA president. All of this is to say, I've spent a lot of time assessing the abundance of blessings I've been given. The most obvious would be my sweet husband, who sets the best example of how to be a Christian. Sometimes that's frustrating. My 4 children are my favorite people to be around, and I'm so thankful for them. I have parents who live in the same city as I do, and they're so fun and generous. I have an abundance of blessings here at First Pres. What a beautiful facility this is. How can you not walk in this church and feel serene and at peace? I love that every Sunday I can count on Donnie and Arlene to sit beside me in the row. Sweet Gwen is always giving me a compliment on my tops or dresses. The Clelands are the most steady presence that I see, and Judy and Kathy are so lovingly interested in me and my children. On the rare occasion that I post something on Facebook, Lou is always posting something positive or affirming. Becky, Cassie, Dave, Marianne, Diane, Noel, Donna, there's so many Becky, there are countless others who are role models to me because they serve. All of the staff are warm and welcome to me. And who doesn't love a big bear hug from Peter? His sermons challenged me at the beginning of the week to be a better person. These gifts are God's abundant blessings to me. Will I be able to match those blessings financially? Not yet. But I'm going to try every year to increase what I'm giving in the hopes that one day it will be in proportion to what God has given me. I challenge you to take the time to acknowledge the true blessings that you've been given. Forget the self-deprecating humor. Forget the rocks that others have burdened you with. And take time to remember what